So, good morning. Yeah, good morning.
Morning.
Yeah, so this morning we are going to discuss a topic on the internet and the email. And this topic I recently submitted last semester is a show. And still, we are not able to complete that. So today we are going to discuss what we call the internet and the email. Have you seen the notes? Joshi, are you able to access the notes? I have just uploaded the notes. So what about Karan? Are you able to see the notes?
But Raina,
That is good. Because I believe now there is not a new topic to use it true. And I think you have interacted with the internet. For example, like now you're using internet to connect to this site. Is it true?
Yes.
I think you have interacted with the email. So this is just a repetition of what you know. Because now we are supposed to have a subject of the irregular, some objectives. And one of the objectives of this topic is that you're supposed to know the internet. You're supposed to know the requirements of connecting to the internet. You're supposed to know the services which are provided by the internet. Still, you're supposed to know the advantages and the disadvantages of what? Of the internet. Still, you're supposed to know the various applications of the internet. That is the part for the whole for the internet. Still, we have some terminologies which are using what in the internet. Then, for the part of the email, you're supposed to know what is an email, the services for, or the advantages and the disadvantages of the whole of the email, and some of the terminologies used in the email. So, for this morning, I will start with the internet. And you know what is internet? For example, internet is what you call is that global interconnection. I think that's a global system. Interconnection of millions of computers which have been interconnected together to form what to call the worldwide web. Because now these computers have to be interconnected worldwide. They form what you call the worldwide web. Because every time, for example, in case you want to access a certain site in the internet, you must have what you call the www. Is it true? So do you see that? In class. Karani.
Yes.
You have to use what you call the World Wide Web, www. Yeah, that is what we call the internet, that global system of millions and millions of computers which have been connected from what you call the World Wide Web. And I say, last time, there's a difference between the internet and the network. In an organization, you can have a network, but there is no what in internet. Now, what are the requirements of connecting to the internet? One of the requirements of to the internet is what you call an ISP. And you know what is an ISP? An ISP is the internet service provider. The internet service provider. So this relates to a company that is able to provide the services. And one of the companies, requirements of connecting to the internet is what you call an ISP, the internet service provider. And you have said, there's a mic which is making a lot of noise. You're saying that we have the ISP, and the ISP, this is a company that provides what? Services. And one of the companies, they have Safaricom. They have which one? You should just give us one. I have said you have Safaricom. Then you have which other company is able to provide the internet services apart from Safaricom?
Airtel,
then Sri Lanka we have
Telkom.
So we have fiber together. So these are the fiber companies. Yeah. Correct, when you have fiber. So they're able to provide what? The internet services, the ISP. So you must have an ISP for you to connect to the internet. That is the first one. Then the second requirement is what you call a terminal. We have what? A terminal. You know what is a terminal? Anyone who knows what is a terminal?
Yes.
A terminal is a device which has a keyboard and a display screen. That's it. So this device must have two things. One of the requirements is what? We are saying a terminal, that is a second device. Or the second requirement, a terminal. And you have to say that a display screen and a key, I'm saying it must have both of them. In case you must have what the key, the keyboard, that information is the display. computer. Is it true? We have a computer. That's two things. A display screen and a keyboard. We have it. You can have the smartphone. It has what? A display screen, a and a key, and a keyboard. That is a what? A terminal. Have you understood?
Yes.
Karan, you understood? Have you understood the terminal? Joshia, have you understood the terminal?
Yeah.
I'm saying, have you understood what is a terminal?
Me, I've not understood. Yes. You're so.
Oh, you're saying?
I can't hear you well.
Oh, there's a mic is having a lot of noise. Let me see this. Who's my guy together?
Yeah.
So, can you ensure that where you are, there's no noise? Are together? Class, are together?
Yes.
So, class, ensure where you are, there's no noise. Because I can hear there's a lot of noise. Yes. You see?
Yes. Yes.
Where you are, there's a lot of noise. Eh? Background noise. Are together?
Yes.
Yeah, just ensure there's no noise. Are together?
Okay.
Yes, Silianka.
Yes.
I hope where you are, there's no noise. Are together?
Yeah.
Yeah, so. Yoshia, I hope you have to. Yeah. So you're saying this, that a terminal is a device having two things. It must have a keyboard and a hot and a display screen. We have seen a good example of a terminal is a hot, is a computer. We have a laptop, you can have a smartphone. It has a keyboard and a hot and a display screen. You must have that connected to the internet. Then another device that can be used or another requirement of going to the internet is what you call a telephone line. And you know what is a telephone line? A telephone line can be either an optic cable, it can be a twisted pair cable, it can be a coaxial cable. So the telephone line it allows the operator from the ISP to the destination. And remember, the destination is the customer. So you must have what the telephone. I mean, we have seen the examples of this. We have the fiber optic, we have the coaxial cable, and you can have what we call a twisted pair cable. And have the twisted pair cable. Another requirement of connecting to the internet is what we call the username, the password. We have the username and the password. Sometimes, in case you are connected to your Wi-Fi, it must have a specific code, your username. But sometimes, the same Wi-Fi can have a password. If it has a password, there is what we call the YP password, the Wi-Fi protected access password. So for you to be able to access the services on that internet, you have to ensure you have the right username and you have the right password. That is what another requirement. Still, we can have another requirement of connecting to the internet. There is what we call the communication software. We have the communication software. Which are these softwares? These are the softwares that provide a simple and easy way of accessing information on the internet. These are the programs or these are the softwares that provide a simple and easy way of accessing information on the internet. Which are these communication softwares? You can have the browsers, you can have Opera Mini, you can have Google Chrome, you can have Mozilla Firefox. So these are some of the communication software. Yeah. Then still, we can have the last requirement of connecting to the internet. There is what you call a modem. I know you know what is a modem. So, Gomia, have you ever come across the term modem?
Yes.
Yeah, what is a modem according to you? What is a modem? Because you have said a modem, it is still a requirement of connecting to the internet. What is a modem according to you? What is a modem?
It's a device that is used for connecting to the internet.
It's a device that is correct. Joshia, what about you? Joshia, what is a modem according to you? Karan, what is a modem? It is a
device that uses a SIM card, which allows a user to connect to the internet and can also be used to receive calls and text messages.
Yeah, it is correct. So actually, a modem is a concatenation of two words. We have modulator, demodulator. So a modem is a device that is used to convert incoming digital signal. It is a device that is used convert incoming digital signal to analog signal so that now it can be transmitted over ordinary telephone lines. Convert what? A digital signal to analog signal. That is what we call modulation. The conversion of a digital signal to analog signal. Then we have the demodulation part. To demodulate now is the opposite of modulation. You convert now that analog signal back to the digital. Have you understood?
Yes.
Yeah, so we have said that a modem has two parts. We have modulation, demodulate, modulation. We have said for the modulation part, it is to convert now that digital signal to analog signal. Then the modulation now is the opposite. You convert now that analog signal back to the digital. So these are some of the requirements of connecting to the internet. And you can have types of modem. You can have an internal modem. You can have what? An internal modem. You can have an external modem. You can have RSD modem. So you have the some of the requirements of connected to the internet software. Now, which software do you know which are using the internet? What to the internet? Go here. Just give us one. Any software you know that can be used to connect to the internet. Any software?
Any?
Let's see. We need to discuss now some of the internet softwares which are used to provide access to the information on the internet. Which software do you know?
HTTP.
Yes?
HTTP.
No, that is a protocol. That is a what? A protocol. Because I will be discussing with that is a protocol. Yeah, that is a protocol.
The software.
Yeah, software. Which software? Any information? What about Karani? Any information about any software that is used in the internet. So let me discuss them. One of the software is called a browser. What a browser? And you know what is a browser? It's a program that provides the user a platform to access the information on the internet. Together a browser together, and I've just discussed how types of browsers together. You can have the Mozilla Firefox. You can have the Google Chrome. So the purpose of a browser it is to translate the code and to display the information on the web, on the web page together. Because now this information is kept in a web server somewhere. Is it true?
Yes.
This information is kept in a web server. So the work of the web browser it is to retrieve the information from the web server by using a protocol called what? The HTTP protocol. Understood? The web browser uses the HTTP protocol to retrieve the information from the web server and then later display the information on the web page. That is a what? A browser. And you have examples of browsers. You have Opera Mini, you can have Google Chrome, you can have Mozilla Firefox, and you can have what you call the Internet Explorer. You can have the Internet Explorer. So what are the uses of these browsers? What are the uses of these browsers? One of the uses of the browser it is to translate the code. To do what? The code? The code. That is the first objective or the first benefit of having a browser. The second advantage or the second use of a browser, it is to give access to the information stored in the web server. To give access to the information stored in the web server is good. Because for example, in case you have a website. You have a website, for example, that website must be having a database. That database is kept in what? In a web server? Understood?
Yes.
The information in that website are kept now in a web server. So for us to have that access, we must have what? A web browser. And still, a browser, it enables the user to over the internet. It enables the user to do what? We are saying another advantage or other benefit of having a browser. It enables the user to navigate over the internet. To do what? To navigate. To navigate now is to move from one website or one site to another what? Another site. For example, in case you're accessing the ZTEC website, you can navigate using the same browser to access what? The KRI website. Understood?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, that is what you call navigation. So these are the internet softwares. And now we have two types of browsers. We have what? Two types of what? Remember, we have examples of browsers and we have types of browsers. For example, we have some browsers whereby you can only access the internet using what? Some browsers. Some browsers can be used to connect when you're offline. Understood?
Yes.
Some can be used to access when you're offline, some when you're online. For example, there is what you call the line mode browsers. The line mode browsers. Let me just type it. The line mode browsers. You have the line mode browsers. You can have them. Line mode browsers. So whenever you come to the term line mode browsers, these are the browsers that can be used to access information when you're online. Understood? When you are online. Line mode browsers. You can only access information when you are online. But we have what we call the Netscape. We have what? The Netscape browsers. We have the Netscape what? Browsers. For these ones, you can only access the information when you're offline. We have the line mode browsers and we have what we call the Netscape browsers.
Netscape.
Line mode browsers. Yeah, Netscape. Yeah, Netscape browser. I think I have. Can you see it? Yeah, we have Netscape what? Browsers. For these ones, you can only access the information when you are online. You can only access the information when you are online. So any question? Any question on the two browsers or any clarification? Have you understood the difference between that you're asking?
The Netscape browser.
Yeah.
You can access information without buying bundles and...
Yeah, you can access in your offline. Yeah. Yeah. They're using organizations altogether. But now they are limited. They are limited the information you can access altogether.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. So I hope you have understood. So Gomi, any question?
No question.
That is good. So we have a Kanani Aniki Yavasa question, and that is good. So now the next subsection I want to discuss now.
We can't hear you.
Internet. Some terminologies. Oh, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, we are saying I want to discuss now some of the terminologies which are used in the internet. Have you come across the terminology, for example, like the word homepage? And if you have ever heard of the term homepage, is it true?
Yes.
Homepage. Now, after the homepage is also called the index page. So the index page. It's called what? The index what? The index page. Actually, the homepage now, it is a page that is displayed every time whenever you open a website. That is displayed every time whenever you open what have a web page. For example, let me just share screen showing you the web page together. A home page together. Let me just share screen. Let me just show you a home page. Let me just show you the home page. Show you one. Let me just share a homepage. Let me just display one homepage. Now, can you see this now? I've just opened the KGRI website. Can you see the homepage altogether? Just click it, you see. Let me just open the homepage. Oh, you cannot access that information that time. Let me just use the different sites to the homepage. So I've just opened a homepage of the ZTEC University website. Just show the homepage, the first page of the index page. It's opening. Can you see the homepage now? Can you see it?
Yes.
Can you see the homepage? We're having the home, about, admissions, academics. That is the homepage. The first page that is That is the home page. Any question on the home page?
Will you pardon it?
We can have the website now. What is? Yes?
My phone logged me off.
Pardon? You're saying we have the home page. And the home page now, this is the first page that is displayed every time whenever you open WhatsApp a website. Sometimes it's called what the edX page. I've just got a screen of the ZTEC website. But together, you can see the home page, what we have. But together, you can see this whole the home page. In the home page now, we have the home, we have the about together. We have the student life, we have the research together. That is what the home page. I think you can see that screen. Can you see it?
Yes.
You can see it. That is good. So that is the first technology that is used in the internet. The second technology is what you call a website now. We have several web pages which have been interconnected together or edited together and stored in our website. So a website is a collection of web pages. There's a collection of web pages which have been interlinked together and stored in the web server. Understood? Yeah. Like now we have a website here. We have the ZTEC website. That is a website. So we can see now, in the case I can navigate now, let me just navigate. You can see, for example, in case I want to access the About Us now, you can see now there are several pages here together. You can see we have the About Us now. We can have the mission here. We can have the governance here, the partners. These are what interlinked to web pages together. Yeah. The collection of web pages which have been interlinked together and stored in a web server. Can you see now that the web pages here? Can you see them?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, you can see now. Well, that is a website. Yeah, that is a website. Then another terminology is what you call a web server. It's called what? A web server. Yep. Actually, a web server is a web server. We have what? A web server. And so now this is a computer that controls and contains information of other clients in a network. It is a computer that contains and controls information of other clients in a network. And a web server must be very, very powerful. It must be what? Very, very powerful. It can be near the computer. But now, what are the characteristics of this web server? Because you are saying it is able to store the information of other clients or other computers in the internet, only in the network. So one of the requirements of the web server, it must be what? Very, very powerful. It must be very powerful. The reason you are saying it's powerful, it is because it's having a large memory. It is having what? A large what? A large memory. It's having a large memory. It is having faster processors. Having what? Faster processors. It has many disk drives. It has what? Many disk drives. For example, the normal computer has one disk drive. Is it true? It has just one disk drive. But for the web server, it can have even 10. So these are the characteristics of that web server. Is a computer that contains and controls the information of other clients in the network. And now we can have the types of web server. You can have what you call a file server. You can have a print server. Understood? You can have a file server. You can have a print server. You can have a database server. You can have the telnet servers. These are some of the examples of what web servers. Another terminology that is used the internet is what you call a hyperlink. We have what? Let me just type it. We have a hyperlink. You can have a hyperlink. You can have a hyperlink. Is it here? Hyperlink. Can you see that?
Hyperlink.
Yeah, hyperlink. If you look at this website here, look at this one, there are several links. For example, I'm here. Can you see here? We are in the home page together. For example, in case I want to access the publications here, there's a link. On this page, there's a link on that page. Mm. Because I just click that now, I'm redirected that page for the publication. So together, there's a hyperlink. So what is a hyperlink? A hyperlink, it allows you to connect different pages. It is a link that allows you to connect what several web pages. So I mean the publications. In case now I want to navigate back to training now, I just click what? Training together. Then you can just click what? Maybe internal training together. Can you see now there's a ring? Yeah, can you see that? Let me just show you. For example, yeah, here, the library, just click that. Are you able to see the ring? No, can you see now? Once I click the library, I'm redirect to this page. Guys, that is a whole, that is a ring. Can you see it now? Can you see that? Able to see that?
Yes.
Yeah,
that is what you call a hyperlink. That is a hyperlink. It allows the interconnection of different web pages. Then another terminology that you don't come across is what you call a bookmark. And for those people who use the Opera Mini, their smartphones, they always see this part, the bookmark. Is it true? Actually, a bookmark now is a list of interesting pages which are part of the favorites. For example, in the case, for example, you have like the ZBS portal, you can bookmark that. Is it true? You can bookmark that so that now every time it provides an easier way of accessing what that site, you can have it as a bookmark. A list of interesting what web pages. What a bookmark. So these are some of the terminologies using the word in the internet. Still, you come across the term the host. The host. You can have the term what the host. You can have that term the what the host. Now, Sumaya.
Yes.
Yeah, what is a host according to you? Have you come across the term host? Yeah, the host.
A host, somebody who's supposed to.
Yeah, but now, that is in real life. But what have you come across the term host in terms of computers? Have you come across that term?
No.
So, whenever you come across that term, now, a host. It is a computer that is used to transfer data on the internet. Host is a what? It's a computer that is used to transfer data on the internet. Host can be a web server. It can be a what? A web server? Web server. That computer has the information. This information can be sent to other computers on a what? On that network. It can be sent to other computers or to other clients who are able to access that information. That is a what? That is a host.
To transfer data? Yeah.
The same, it is used to transfer data to other clients in the network or the internet. For example, a web server can be a host. Why? The source of the information is on that computer. Understood?
Yes.
Yeah, that is good. Then you always come across another term, the domain name. We can have this term, domain name. We can have that term. Domain what? You can have domain. You can have domain name. So, Joshi, have you come across the term domain? What is the domain, Joshi? What is the domain? The domain. Because, for example, in case you have a website, or in case you have a page on the internet, it must have a domain, or that website must have a domain. Have you come across the term domain?
No.
What about Sumai? Have you come across the term domain?
Again, I just know it in the literal definition. Not with the computer.
Yeah. What is the domain according to you? Yeah. Maybe just give us letters here. What is the domain according to you?
Domain, like something, your area, what you own.
What you own? Yeah, that is in real life. Yeah. Maybe I'll speak about in computers. Kimathi.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, Kimathi, where have you been? Yeah, Kimathi, have you come across the term domain?
Yes.
Yeah, what is a domain?
A domain contains a group of computers that can be accessed and administered with a common set of rules. A domain contains a group of computers that can be accessed and administered.
Yeah.
With a common set of rules.
Yeah, that is good. For example, maybe we can have, for example, let me just give an example of a domain. We can have, for example, let me just type one. Let me just type one for you. You can have this domain. You can have like this one, www.maybe.villageclub, village.glass.co.ke. Can you see that domain? Can you see that domain I've typed? Can you see it? Can you see that?
Yeah.
No. Can you see it on the chat group here? I've just typed a domain. If you look at this domain now, we have the last part here, .ke, are together? Now that part here represents the country. Represent what the country. The first part, the village class, represents what the username, or the name of that domain. Then the last part here, ke, represents what the country. So a domain is a description or a representation of a computer's location on the internet. Is that what? A description or a representation of a computer's location on the internet. So in case now, whenever you see, understood, you're saying is a description or a representation of a computer's location on the internet. And you have said the first part here, the village craft, represent what? The name of the domain together. Then the last part here, NE, represent what? The country. So we know now, in case you hear, you come across this domain on the internet, it's from which country?
Okay.
So in case you come across this domain on the internet, it's from Kenya, is it true? It's from Kenya. Yeah, because you're having .ke, .ke.
Mm-hmm.
What if now, what if now you come across a domain or another subsection, it is having .com. Because you have a domain having .com, it means comma, commercial. Understood?
Yes.
In case you see a domain having .com, it means what, comma, commercial. In case you see .ac, you can have like this one. For example, you have, let me just show you one. Now, can you see this one here? Let me just show you. Let me just share screen here. Mm. Just show you one for ZTech. It's having .ac. Let me just show you one. Now, can you see this one here? Can you see this one having .ac.ke? Can you see that? Are you able to see that? .ac, let me just show you. Let me just share screen showing you that domain. Now, can you see this part here? Can you see .ac.ke? Can you see that part? Are you able to see that part? There's that part I written on that website. Can you see it? Let me just show you. You can have this. For example, you can have that. Now, this is the mechanism for. I've just typed it on the chat group. Can it be having .ac? And is that part .ac? Now .ac means that it is academic. It is what academic. So even institution which is having, which is, or any institution must have .ac. They must have .what? .a. It means mean what is academic. You understood? So have you understood?
Yes.
Yeah. Can you understood?
Yes.
Imagine.
Yeah.
Yeah, Joshia?
Yeah.
Sumaya?
Yes.
Yeah, that is good. So that is what you call a domain name. Now there is what you call, there is another terminology called an IP address. What? An IP address. So an IP address or what you call the internet protocol. The internet what protocol. So this is a unique number that is used to identify a computer on the internet. Is that what? A unique number that is used to identify a computer on the internet. A unique number that is used to identify a computer on the internet. So we can have an IP address. For example, we can have 192.168.10.56. That is the word. This is an example of what? An IP address. Right together. 192.168.10.56. That unique number that is used to identify a computer on the internet. Every device on the internet has what you call an IP address. Even your smartphone has what? An IP address. Now, do you know how to obtain IP address of a computer? Do you know how to obtain? Do you know how to obtain an IP address of a computer?
No.
I'll show you just now. Kimathi, can you obtain the IP address of a computer?
No.
No? What about Joshia?
No.
What about Sumaya? Can you access the IP address of your computer? I want to show you. Don't do that just now.
No.
So what you have to do, like I will be sharing a screen together on the procedure of how you can obtain the IP address of a computer, because they have said it is a unique number that is easy to distinguish or to identify any computer on the internet. There is no way you can have two computers having the same IP address together. But now it depends. Is it dynamic or static? In a static environment, we cannot have computers having the same IP address. But in the case now you're having a static environment or a static connection, can have two computers having what? The same IP address. Now, I want you to state now the procedure of obtaining the IP address of my computer. Let me just show you. Through the procedure. So for you to obtain the IP address of my computer, you have to come to the start button. And so now we have the start button here. You have what? The start bar button together. Then you just type CMD. You type what? CM command prompt CMD is here. Can you see it?
Yes, sir.
Can you see that? You just go to the start button and you just type what? The CMD. Can you see that? Command prompt.
Yes.
Then you just press enter. Just press what? Just press enter. Then you just type IP config. IP what? IP config? Config. Can you use that command? IP config. IP config. IP config. Can you see that?
Yes.
Then you just, press enter. Once you press enter here, it's here. Can you see it here? Can you see the IPv at the internet protocol version 4 address? Can you see it here? 182.168.43.94. Can you see the IP address?
Yes.
That is how you obtain the IP address of a computer. It's a unique number that divides each device to the internet. Any question? Any question?
Can one access someone's computer using the IP address?
There is a, you know, there is a way even you can switch off the computers in a network. They are using the IP address. Together, there's some commands you can use now to switch off the computers in the network to switch them off. Together, but now it varies. There's a mechanism you can use to switch them off. But together, still, a computer can be hacked using the IP address. Still, together, in case someone is able to obtain the IP address of your computer and he's a hacker. But together, he's using the Linux operating system. But together, he's using what Linux. He can obtain the information. He can hack it using the IP address. But together, yeah.
Yes.
Any question?
Can you change the IP address of a computer?
Yeah, you can change the IP address. Together, for example, let me just share that. Let me just show you the procedure. I just go to the network, to the what? To the network. Let me just show you. Just show you the procedure. I'll just have to open my network together. I have to open what? The network.
Okay.
My network. Can you see that? Are you able to see?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm accessing my network settings. I'm accessing what my network settings. I hope you can see that. Can you see that?
Yes.
Yeah, let me just show you. Now, can you see now? We have this party. Are you able to see obtain an IP address automatically? Can you see that part? So what happens now? Currently my computer is using what? A dynamic IP address. It is automatically together. But in case now I want to use the static one or I want to modify it, I have to click this part. Can you see now?
Yes.
Can you see now use the following IP address? I want to change. I want to do what? I want to change it together.
Yes. Yeah.
Can you see I'm switching? Let me just
yes.
I'm changing to 192.168, maybe dot 15. We can have the. Can you see now we're having that?
Yes.
Can you see now I have changed? So my new IP address is 192.168.15.8. Then I have to validate. I have to validate and click OK. Can you see I have clicked OK? So can you see now it is using a new IP address? Can you see this? Can you see?
Yes. Yes.
So that is how you can change it with the IP address altogether. Yeah. Any other question? So any other question?
For example, in a say in a computer lab.
Yeah.
When everyone is logged into the internet.
Yes, there's a mic which is having a lot of echoes.
Oh, I'm so saying.
Talking, yeah.
For example, when students are in a computer lab.
Yeah.
And they are logged into the internet.
Yeah.
Must their IP address be same or they can be different?
Yeah. Sometimes we have two mechanisms. We have what we call a dynamic and you have a static. For example, in case now that network has been configured to have a dynamic, once you log into that network, every computer is given or every smartphone is given a unique IP address by the server. Understood?
Yes.
But in case now you're using it is static, you can even change your IP address. You can change your IP address.
Mm-hmm.
Like now my mind was dynamic initially. Is it true?
Yes.
And I was able to change to static, to manual. So, in case you're using static IP address, there is a possibility that you can have two IP addresses which are the same. And they cause correction. They cause what correction in the network. Yeah. So understood.
Yes.
Yeah, that is good. So another terminology you always come across on the internet is what you call an FTP. An FTP. This is a protocol. The file transfer protocol. So here, let me just type it, the file. Transfer protocol. You can have this. What transfer? What protocol? The FTP. Now, the purpose of this one, it enables the user to transfer data from the web server to the computer. This is what you call the FTP protocol, the file transfer protocol. It is a method of transferring files between computers on the internet. The FTP. Yeah, in case you want to transfer some documents from two computers. For example, I'm having my computer is here. Is it true? I'm having my computer here, and I want to obtain or to send some information, maybe to Kimathi's computer. I can use an FTP. I can use what an FTP. Yeah. Then there is what you call. We have there's another terminology called. We have a telnet. We have what the telnet. Have a telnet. Have. Yeah, this one. So speed internet, there is a technology that allows what you call the remote logging in or the remote control. For example, because you are using the internet, there is a way you can control a computer which is miles away using what the internet. Understood?
Yes.
Yeah,
that is. So we have the internet. Yeah. So these are some of the terminologies which are using the internet. And we have discussed several. Any question before I proceed to the services provided by the internet? Any question at that point? Any question?
Does file transfer protocol,
yeah,
does it work when computers are together in one room or it can work when they are separate?
It can work even when they are 10 kilometers away. Not together?
Yes.
Yeah, because now the main connection, you must have the internet. You must have the internet. And I'll be demonstrating, maybe once we assume, I'll be demonstrating or maybe I can demonstrate now together. Let me just demonstrate one together.
Yes.
I hope you're able to see it. Let me just switch on another laptop. I show you together.
Yes.
Yeah, let me just illustrate. Let me just show you one. I want to control another computer together.
Yes.
Yeah. Let me just show you. just hold on. Are you together?
Yes.
Yeah, I want to illustrate now. I want to control a different computer. I want to control a different computer. Which is just show you. Let me just show you. So the computer is near to me, but now I'll be using this computer to access the information on that computer together. Yeah. Yes. I can even switch off the computer together when I'm in this computer. Let me just, it's powering up. Let me just illustrate that. At least you're able to start the telnet. And now I want to open there's a software called the TeamViewer. I want to use this software called over the TeamViewer. Yeah. In the TeamViewer now, I want to control a different laptop. For you to control this laptop now, you have to ensure you have internet access. Together, you have what? Internet access. Okay. Let me just share the screen. Let me just find the application. Let me just open it. So can you see this over here? Can you see it? Are you able to see this one? Can you see it? Can you see the team viewer?
Yeah.
Can you see this one? So I have opened my team viewer. So once open the team viewer, can you see we have this part here? It has two things. It has remote control that is telnet. It can have a transfer. Can you see it here for transfer for the FTP?
Yes.
Then we have the remote control. Now I will be using the remote control or the telnet. I want to control a different computer. That computer, it can be even in the US. Together.
Yes.
So what happens now? The two computers must be having this software called the telnet, called the TeamViewer. So in the computer, it has a partner ID. It has what? A partner ID. For example, like my computer, it has what? My unique ID. Can you see it here? Can you see the unique ID? Can you see it here? This one?
Yes.
Yeah. So,
then it has its unique what? Password. But now the password varies. Can you see it's varying? Can you see it has changed the password?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, but you realize what it means. So what I have to do, I will pick my account, my other laptop's IP address, not IP address, but an ID, and just place it here together. Can you see the ones I've ever connected? Let me just pick the IP address.
We can't hear you.
Let me see. Oh, I'm saying I want to obtain my other partner's ID in the laptop together.
Yes.
Actually, when I'm using this software, even I can control your laptop. Even I can even switch it off wherever you are. But I have to have the partner ID that is powering up the software. Just 1 minute. Yeah, I obtain the partner ID. Now my partner ID is here. Can you see now? My other computer is on ID. Can you see it?
Yes.
Can you see it? I'm typing. Yeah, we have it. That is what my other laptop's partner ID. Can you see connect here? Can you see connect?
Yes.
Yes.
Can you see connect? I'll just click connect. Let me just connect. It is connected. Can you see now it is connecting here? So I'll be prompted to input the password. It's connecting. That's C is connecting. Now, can you see now it is prompting me to put it all together? Can you see, please enter the password that is displayed on your father's computer? So the password of my computer, the computer is supposed to be 75ABC3. That is the password. I'm just logging. Can you see now I'm logging in? Have you seen? Yes. Have you seen? Yes. Let me just log into that computer. Now it is connecting. As you can see now, it's connected to that computer. I want to control it. The name of that computer is here. Yeah, was PC. Can you see that is the name of that computer? Is here.
Mm-hmm.
It is here. Can you see? It is here. Can you see there's a start button? Can you see?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Are you able to see? Now my computer is using Windows 10, but my other computer is using Windows 7. Can you see now I'm able to connect? I can even access the information on that computer. Can you see what is happening?
Yes.
Can you see now I can even access the information? That is what we call it. We are having telnet. I can access the documents here. I can access the documents which are here. And just access them. For example, in case I want to delete some information, I'll just do that and I click delete. And I click what? Delete? Delete.
Mm.
Now, can you see now? I'm deleting using my laptop the information on different computer. So, what is happening on that computer? The mouse is moving together. Yeah. For example, I can just come here and delete. For example, you have this information. Can you see the software here? Can you see it? I just click on delete. But even now, I want to switch off. I want to change the setting of the network in that computer. I just come to, I'm using it to save it. I've just got this. Not even system properties. I'm supposed to have the network. Network, control panel. Let me just change the network settings. Network and internet. Just use the means which I can use. I've just got this part here. We just go to network. Now, can you see the computer I'm connected to? Can you see this one? Can you see? This is here. Then I just go to the network. Is here. Maybe for example, how to manage the wireless settings, the adapter settings. Can just change remote train. That is what I'm doing. Are you able to see?
Yes.
Yeah, this is remote control. This is telnet. And once I'm through, I will switch the computer off. Remotely. Can you see that even I can change the IP address? Can you see now remotely? Can you see?
Yes. Yeah.
And now I want to switch that computer remotely. Or for example, even I can access a site. Let me access a site remotely. This is the desktop of that computer. The desktop of that what? Computer. So for example, maybe I want to browse now. I just come to this part here of that computer. I'm opening now the web browser on that computer. Can you realize that computer is a bit? Can you see it is a bit slow? That computer. It's a bit slow. Or maybe even I can just push it off. Can you see now we have the start button here? Can you see? Or it's open the browser now. Just open the browser. Is here the browser. You can just open, for example, you have the ZTEC. Now I'm doing this remotely. I'm doing that remotely. This remote control. So have you understood the internet now? Have you understood?
Yes.
Yeah, so now I want to switch that computer off. that remote computer. Once I switch off, it will close the, just close, shut down, maybe just shut it down. It will disconnect it. Just shut it down. Let us see the effect. That is remote control. Just shut it down. Now, can you see it is logging off? Can you see it has logged off? Have you seen?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, that is remote control. Any question?
Can you switch it on remotely?
Now, can you see now there's a message displayed here? Can you see now the message here? Your partner team view will not be unavailable. Why? It has been switched off. Okay. Understood? Yeah, so for you to control it, it has to be on. It has to be powered on. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So for I to access it now, I have to ensure it is on. Together. So we are back. I hope you know you have understood. Any question?
Yes.
Yeah, ask. Yo, okay. Any question? Joshia, any question?
No.
Imadi, any question?
Oh.
Karani, any question?
I'm okay for now.
Sumaya?
No question.
That is good. Then we have a new visitor called Mwaula. More any question? So now we can discuss now the services provided by the internet. I think that the services and one of the services provided by the internet is what we call the email. We have all the email, what we call the electronic mail. It provides a method of exchange information electronically with the people around the world. That is all the email. It provides a mechanism to exchange information globally around the world by using what an email together. So that is one of the services yeah. is provided by the internet. We have what an email. That is the first one. Still, we can have another service. We can have what we call the e-commerce. We have what the e-commerce for the online shopping. For example, in case you want to buy a product from Jumia, that is e-commerce. Is it true? You can just go to it. You can just log into your website and just add the items to the cart. Is it true?
Yes.
Is it true? Yeah.
Yes.
That is the e-commerce. Still, we can have another site. For example, we have Jumia is an e-commerce site. We can have Kilimall. Which other site do we have? We have Jumia is the main Kilimall, and we have DigiKenya. Is it true? Mm-hmm. You have it, Joshia.
Yeah.
Which site do you know? For example, in case you want to buy, for example, a smartphone online, apart from Jumia, Kilimall, and DigiKenya, which other site can you use to buy an item online for e-commerce?
Amazon.
Yeah.
Amazon.
Yeah. So we have Amazon. Yeah, that is correct. So that is another service which is provided by the internet. We have what we call the e-commerce or the online shop. Shopping. Another service which is provided by the internet is what we call the e-learning. We have the e-learning, electronic learning. Like, you know, you're having an e-learning. Is that true? You're having what an e-learning. You don't have to. There's no physical connection between the student and the learner. You just access the information via what an online form. That is what we call the e-learning. Still, there is no entertainment. There is what we call entertainment. Another service provided by the internet. You have entertainment. Now, do you have to explain what is internet? What is entertainment? Because I believe most of you are able to stream live music from YouTube. Is it true? Sumaya?
Yes.
Sumaya, maybe you can explain yes. to us now. Internet. You can explain now to us now. The internet in respect of the internet. The entertainment in respect of internet. Entertainment.
Okay.
You're saying. suppose we have said entertainment is a service which is provided by the internet. Entertainment. Maybe you can explain now how the internet has helped in entertainment. Maybe just give us a scenario how the benefit.
There's YouTube.
Yeah, YouTube. What are you doing, YouTube? Yeah, you can access videos, that is correct. What about Kimazin? Imagine anything else in the entertainment industry.
Netflix.
Yeah, we can have Netflix about movies altogether. That is what entertainment. Still, we can have another service which is provided by the internet. There is what you call the video conferencing. The video conferencing or web conferencing. For example, you can hold meetings online. For example, like now we are holding what class online. That is what video conferencing. But now, in that now, you have to share your, for example, the webcam. Just show you, just a straight one. Just the video conferencing. So this is video conferencing. You can even share the video online. Can you see the video conferencing? Can you see that? So you can even hold a meeting online together. You don't have the corner between the person, the host, and the person, and the people attending that. What that mean? Is provided video conference. We have no service which is provided. We have information. We have all information for what you call the research. We have all the research. For example, in case I give an assignment and you want to obtain the information, you have to go to the internet. Is it true? Mm-hmm. Most of you have the information from the internet. That is what you call we have the research. Still, another advantage of the internet or another service provided by the internet. Still, there is what you call discussion groups. Or we have news groups. You can form discussion groups based on a topic. You can have some discussions with the people around the world. So these are some of the services provided by the internet. But now, some of these services, they act as what? They are different advantages. Understood? That is what? They are different advantages. Because now, one of the advantages of the internet is what you call access to the email. Is it true? Access to the email we have. Buying and selling of product online, we have online chat, we have entertainment, we have access to information, we have access to research, access to education platforms. So these they form the advantages of the internet. But still, the same internet has some disadvantages. That's what some disadvantages. One of the disadvantages of the internet is what you call the virus threat. You have what? Virus threat. In the case now, you're in the internet and your computer do not have an antivirus. We have a lot of malware on the internet. So it can be infected by the whole by the computer viruses altogether. So understood? So have you understood? Yes. The first one.
Yeah.
You have what virus threat. Computers attached to the internet are more prone to what virus attacks. We can have malware, like we can have Trojan horse. We have the time bomb viruses. We have what you call, we have the macroviruses. That is what one of the disadvantages. The second disadvantage of the internet is what you call accessing unethical sites. Access what? Unethical sites. Some people, they're able to access what? Pornographic sites. And this has led to what you call moral degradation in the society. Why? This is a result of the internet. So internet can lead to what you call moral degradation by accessing what? Pornographic sites. Another disadvantage is what you call the time wasted in workplace. We have what you call the time wasted in workplace. We have time wasted in what? In workplace. Most of the workers spend most of their time surfing the internet. Hence, they give little attention to their jobs. For example, you are at workplace. Maybe you're working in a certain organization. Instead of working, you just have the internet. And it's very, very common. Very, very, very common. See, that is what a disadvantage. Same message in what in workplaces. Then there is what you call web crime. I think you have heard about hacking Rivetcom. Is it true, Karani? Have you about hacking web crime?
Yes.
Yeah, we can have. We can in terms of web crime, there's a lot of hacking going on. We can have hacking, IP spoofing, spoofing. We can have farming. So these are some of the web crimes committed to the, or which is a result of the internet. So another disadvantage of the internet is what we call access to personal information. Access to what? To personal information. For example, in case you buy an item online using your credit card, using what? Your credit card. Sometimes that information can be accessed by what? By a third party. It can be accessed by what? A third party. So these are some of the disadvantages of the internet. Still, internet is expensive. Why? Yeah, especially for example, in the rural areas where there is no power, you cannot access what the internet. It is very expensive, especially in those places whereby there is no electricity. So these are some of the disadvantages of the internet. So any question at that point, because we are through on the internet. What is the meaning of the internet now? We'll be discussing the next class, because I'm supposed to give you a discussion now. Not together. I'm supposed to give you a discussion whereby you're supposed to discuss the impact of internet in learning institutions. Right together. So any question at that point? Any question?
No.
Yeah, so have you understood? So Kimathi, any question? Or Joshia, any question?
No.
Sumaya, any question?
No.
So now we are through with the video conferencing. So everything, what were your challenges today? Or were you able to understand everything? Were you able to understand? Or what were your challenges today?
Pardon?
Were you having any challenges today in the class? Any major challenge so we can improve next time? Any challenge?
There's no challenge.
There's no challenge. Sumaya? Sumaya, any challenge?
No.
Yeah, so you're able to understand the information. So I think if once you access this platform, there is a discussion that is said. Have you seen it? You're supposed to discuss now the impact of internet in the learning system. Have you seen it on this platform? Have you seen it?
Mm-hmm.
No, once you access there's a platform where you saw lecture two class. At the bottom, let me just share the screen right together. Let me just show you what it is. Let me just show you. Work on this discussion. I want to see the feedback. Can you see this part here? Can you see this one? Question. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Are you able to see this one? It's loading. Are you able to see it? Explain 5 impacts of internet in learning institution. Can you see that?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, I want to work on that now. I want everyone to provide the 5 impacts. And an impact can be a positive or a negative. I'll mark it together. You just work on that now. Once you post, I'll mark them together.
Okay.
Yeah, so that is good. So I'll end my video conferencing at that point. So we'll meet next time together, but I'll mark now. I'll preview the discussion together. Yeah.
Okay.
So have a good, and inform your friends together of this class. Just inform them we have continued. And so they are supposed to join together, because now they are losing a lot of information, because like today I've illustrated the telnet, and they have lost all that information. Yeah, so have a good day.
Okay. Sure.